My name is Chris Palmer with chrispalmer.org, and in this keyword research video, what I would love to just share with you is a simple tip that will massively impact your overall success over time. So I don't want to waste any time. I want to share with you two tools, first and foremost, that will help you on your quest for keyword research. For very quick access, this tool that's right here that's showing up in the green, right here at the top showing volume, is called Keywords Everywhere. For quick insights on keyword volume, Keywords Everywhere. I'm not promoting it. There's no links. It's just a good tool. The other one for competitive analysis, and stick with me, I have the tip here. I'll share with you in a minute. The other tool that I'll be utilizing in this video is called Semrush. All right. Semrush is great for competitive analysis. It does so many different things. I could go on for days, but these are the two tools that I'll be sharing with you today in order to come up with answers to help your business. Now, I want to point something out to the effect of only having so much time, right? Because I want to just make this clear, and I'm sure you already know this. When you have a website, looking at this example, website.com, that's a homepage, right? That homepage needs images. That homepage needs content. That homepage needs to be interlinked, optimized. It also is going to need backlinks and a plethora of other small odds and ends, speed optimization, all types of stuff. And that's just one page. On top of that, if you have a primary service that you have identified, for this example that I'll be talking with you today about, we're going to use plumber. But let's say you've identified your primary service as plumber. You have a top level page, just like this example here. We have our homepage, then the page, and we have to go through the process again. Create the content, optimize the content, get images, interlink it. Also, we're going to have to start building links. So that means I'm spending resources and time, and I have to find these things, right? There's a lot of time and money invested. Plus, there's the timeline in order for Google to catch up to the work that we've done, right? So what I'm getting at here is if you've identified, looking at number one here, your primary services, and you have identified your primary locations, and you want to start looking at secondary services and secondary locations, that's where this tip right now is going to come into place. Because recently I had a business owner, or I have a business owner that I was trying to help. They are a plumber in Paramus, New Jersey. I might have changed some details, but the parameters are the same. It's a plumber, they're in a city, okay? Now, as you can see here, when I look up plumber Paramus, New Jersey, there's 110 visitors per month, okay, that are searching for this specific term, right? Now, a page ranks for more than one keyword. So this makes perfect sense. Now, when I talk to him, he's like, hey, I have a competitor that's showing up for all types of keywords. And one of the secondary keywords that I want to add is drain cleaning plus city. So I did a very simple search. I searched for that keyword, drain cleaning Paramus, New Jersey. Now, looking at Keywords Everywhere, I quickly identified that there's no search volume, as you can see here. So what I did is I found that competitor. I looked down the list here. And I actually got this person's website. Now, again, this is just an example just to share with you how to do competitive analysis and make sure that you're targeting the right keywords for your investment and your time. So what I did is I just grabbed the website and I want to see, because at the end of the day, what we're doing here is we're creating a page, almost like a fishing, like a lure in the water. And it's like, if I create this page and I cast my, you know, if I cast out, am I going to catch a fish, or do I have a high likelihood of catching a fish, or in this instance, a visit, a click, a phone call? So we only want to be targeting keywords that have the highest probability to generate leads and traffic and clicks. And how we can quickly identify these particular keywords is by looking at who's already ranking above us. So for this particular example, to bring it back, if we look at drain cleaning in Paramus, we can see there's no search volume, but the client says he sees them everywhere. So you find the person that is seen everywhere or ranking for a keyword that you want to rank for, and look at them inside of a tool like Semrush. You don't have to only use Semrush, but it makes it quick. So we take their website and put it into Semrush, and we could see that this particular website only gets 19 visits per month. In fact, if you scroll down, we can see that their top keywords are actually having nothing to do with where we want to rank or in the area that we want to rank in. And on top of that, it's only 19 visitors per month. So they have top ranking positions. They're in a spot that we want to be in, but it's only generating 19 clicks per month. And that's the whole site. So that brings me back. Do I want to invest the time and resources to A, create the page, optimize the page, get the images, do the keyword research, do the gap analysis, get backlinks, create, right? Think of all the work that goes into it in order to be able to produce 19 clicks. And that's the tip for today. I want to share with you how to identify your primary services, figure out what the search volume is, and then take a look at top performers to see, well, if I get to that position, what type of traffic and business will I actually receive? Or at least have a rough idea. And this is how you identify primary services and secondary services to actually target. On top of that, this is how you can identify locations to target. Because in Paramus, looking at this example, they might only be getting, you know, one or two clicks per month, but maybe in Newark or another city, it's doing very well, right? So this is going to help you identify which services are best to target and what secondary services are best to target. On top of that, it'll also help you pick out which locations. And you want to do this with a combination of, hey, is there actually volume? Do I offer this service? And if I were to put in all the work and the effort to rank, will it actually produce traffic, which then could turn into leads, phone calls, and jobs for me? And that's the main tip for today. Utilizing these tools to look and analyze competitors before you execute on doing the actual work. Because it's one thing to do keyword research and know, hey, there's keyword volume. But it's another part of keyword research to take a look at the spot that you want to be in and see, hey, is this traffic worth all the work that I have to do in order to get there? And that's how you make your decisions, and that's how you do your keyword research and your competitive analysis. My name is Chris Palmer with chrispalmer.org. If you have any questions related to keyword research, local SEO, anything, never hesitate to ask in the section below, and I always look forward to seeing you in the next Keyword Research for Small Business SEO video. Have a great day. Bye-bye.